what decision would you make? Do you not
it's
think
not
we
up to
did
me
the
to
right
decide
thing?
that.
Okay. So why are you so pissed off about what we did?
I'm pissed off about what you did.
Mm-hmm.
No. I'm pissed off. I'm not even pissed off. I just find it funny how you can go full sure on something when you don't know.
Well, Mike, when somebody tells me that they were present when a man killed an 8-year-old girl.
Somebody told you that.
Mm-hmm. She did.
Okay.
When that happens, okay, we don't say, oh, well, maybe after we go golfing for the week, we'll go and see Mike and see what he has to say. That's not the way it works.
No, so let's just pick him up and then say, yep, you did it. Because that's obviously got to be the right way to go about things.
Yeah, well, community safety is the important thing here, right?
Okay, well, I'm pretty sure I'm not going anywhere right now, so that doesn't justify what you're saying or doing.
Do you have any kids of your own, Mike?
I guess you'll find out.
Do you have any nieces or nephews?
I guess you'll find out.
Yeah. Somebody told us you have a 7-year-old daughter. Is that true?
I guess you'll find out.
Okay. Well, if you did, and this happened to her, and I came over to your house and said, hey, Mike, we just had somebody tell us who abducted and murdered your daughter. We'll look into it, see what comes up. Would you be happy with that?
Yes. That's your job.
Yeah, because you wouldn't want us to go and arrest somebody just because somebody told us they did a murder, right?
Of course not.
No.
Why would I want somebody just to get arrested just because some Joe Blow said so? Like, then everybody might be arrested because everybody thinks that everybody did it. So let's just arrest a whole lot of them.
Why do you think Terry Lynn would confess to this?
I have no idea.
I mean, let's face it, if Terry
because
Lynn
he says Terry Lynn's on a video. Looks like Terry Lynn's out of options. Terry Lynn's already in a juvie. Terry Lynn already has priors. Terry Lynn has already been accused of stabbing people. I don't know.
But we didn't arrest Terry Lynn until Terry Lynn told us she was involved, right?
Okay.
She came in here for a chat.
Okay.
Okay. We asked her permission to come out on a judge's order and come and talk to us. Okay. It wasn't until Terry Lynn told me that she was involved in this all started to happen. Okay, so this isn't Terry Lynn getting arrested and trying to save her own throat by throwing it on Mike.
I don't know. Maybe Terry Lynn thought she was out of options. I don't know.
Well, for a girl who thought she was out of options, she should have given us a hell of a lot of details.
I can't answer you. I don't know.
How many more sexual assault allegations are going to be on the databases for you?
I guess we'll find out.
Assuming there's more.
I guess you'll
find
out. Right. Like you're getting a hold of things.
Yeah.
Are we done?
I'm not done. Are you done?
I'm done.
Okay. So, the last thing I cover off with everybody I talk to in situations like this, Mike, is pretty straightforward. Okay. Rodney Stafford and Terry McDonald have to be notified about this. Okay. First question out of their mouth is going to be, what? Did they say why they did it?
I'm sure one of those two will have the answer for you, why somebody would do it.
What are you getting at? What are you throwing out there for me, buddy?
It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. You're going to talk to them anyways.
You know what, Mike? if you're going to claim you have no involvement whatsoever, don't play games with me and throw little hints and see what comes of it.
No game. There's no little hints.
There's nobody involved in this except for you and Terry Lynn.
Once again, you're just going to believe whatever you want to believe, based on what some girl has told you. See, whatever. This is why I said I'm done. This is why, from this point on, nothing else comes from my mouth. And if you want to speak to somebody, you can speak to who may be representing me.
We do that all the time.
Perfect.
But we don't have a need to talk to them. That's what the Crown attorneys do.
Okay, well then the Crown will talk to them. I've already given you my answers. They're not good enough for you.
What do you think was going to happen, Mike? You think you were going to walk in here and say, I wasn't involved? Okay, Mike, sorry, Father, you can go now?
Maybe.
Well, one of the things we have to assess is who looks like they're being more truthful. Okay? And I sat through a long, long conversation with Terry Lynn today. I saw her try and tell me she wasn't involved. I saw her try and resist. I saw her try and dig in like you're digging in now. Okay? And then the light came on for her. She started to realize that it was kind of weird that 2 months ago, 3 months ago, whenever it was, here comes Mike out of the blue, walking up to run a pizza place because he saw her walking in there and just thought she was just so stunning that he just couldn't drive by. As we're talking, the light starts to come on a little bit more, and she starts to realize that, yeah, that's freaking weird. That doesn't happen to people every day. Okay, but you're a pretty smooth talker, right?
Sure.
Well, there's lots of people who are going to come out of the woodwork to say that, Mike, okay?
Okay.
All right. We got a girl in here tonight. I don't even know her name because I've been dealing with you. Talking about how she met you and the kind of guy you are. Right? She's not going to be at your bail hearing in the morning. She's not going to be your biggest supporter.
Who would that be?
I don't even know her name. Blonde girl, saw her on the video.
Saw her on the video.
Yeah. She was in another interview room. You can find her name out for you if you're that interested.
Sure.
She's not banging around anymore. You got the girl in London. You apparently wined and dined. And
which girl in London did I wine and dine?
I don't know her name.
Exactly.
The report. Is it going to give me credibility if I go get the report, Mike, and walk in here and tell you what her name was?
No. But it wouldn't sound like such a bullshit story. But whatever.
Are you trying to tell me that you weren't interviewed by London police in January about a date rape allegation where a girl said you drugged her?
What does that have to do with what you just said?
Just what I said.
That's who you're talking about?
That's all the women in your life, okay?
That's
all the women in your
life,
Mike, are going to come out and they're going to talk about how much of a slime ball you are and how sleazy you are.
Well, just because I'm sleazy doesn't make me a... what I'm being accused of. Those are two totally different things. I can see that. It's funny how you can't see that.
What do you want me to see? What do you want to see,
Mike? It doesn't matter. It doesn't make a difference what you see.
Like how many days have you spent in jail?
None.
you understand that for the first degree murder of an 8-year-old girl, the chances of you getting bail are slim to none, right?
Okay.
You understand that? Okay, having done this job for 20 years, all right, I'm not going to give you any false hopes.
Okay.
So what you're telling me is that here's Mike, who's never spent a night in jail, but is now willing to spend probably, in my experience, 18 months to 3 years before this even reaches trial. And then he's going to be vindicating himself somehow. But you'll just suck up that 18 months to 3 years in jail.
I never said that. But once again, what does that have to do with this?
Well,
nothing.
See, I would expect that somebody, an innocent man, would at least be saying to me, can I call, who knows, my boss, my cousin, my neighbor, somebody who can tell you where I was on the 8th of April, who can tell you I wasn't driving around Woodstock and Guelph with an 8-year-old girl and Terry Lynn McClintock in my car. Anybody, any alibi. 3 hours people have been talking to you now. Not once have I heard you say, I'm innocent, talk to this person. I'm innocent, talk to that person. They'll tell you where I was that day. They'll tell you what job site I was on or what thing I was working at that day. We're talking 3:30 in the afternoon. See that, Mike, that would make sense to me, because that would mean that if that person spoken to tonight, we could turn around and say, holy crap. And then Mike wouldn't have to spend a night in jail, wouldn't it?
So if I tell you where I was, who I was with, what I was doing, you're going to let me go?
If it's valid.
How long does it take to validate that?
I don't know. It depends who it is and where they are.
Roughly. How long before I'm out?
Mike, who am I talking to? Where are they? How do I get a hold of them? How can I answer that question until you tell me who these people are?
If these people are into things of their own, does this mean they're going to get in trouble?
Mike, I can tell you this. I've probably talked to over 100 people in the last 5 weeks, myself alone. My investigators, probably over 500 people. I'd say at least half of those people are either drug dealers, drug users, fraud artists, whatever. They've all admitted it. They've all been investigated for it. Not one of them has been charged with a criminal offense. Because our goal is one, to find that kid. April?
had a few people I was supposed to meet that canceled that week. I had somebody over the morning when all the helicopters were going crazy. To London in the afternoon. I'm gonna wait till I talk to my lawyer tomorrow.
I think that would be a good idea, Mike, because one of the things you have to be aware of is if you create a situation, okay, where somebody else ends up stepping up and trying to be your alibi, and if their story is investigated and shown not to be true, they can be charged with accessory after the fact of murder.
Well, their story will be true.
Again, I'm sitting here wondering why I'm giving you the opportunity. You want me to be fair? You want me to listen to both sides?
I'm tired. I'm exhausted. I'm still hungry. It's been a long day.
And the next 25 years of your life are on the line, Mike.
Then it can wait one more day when I talk to a lawyer and I know exactly all my rights.
You have two rights. You can talk to a lawyer, which you've done. And you can keep your mouth shut.
I have a lot more rights than that.
Like what?
Well, I don't know. That will be for the lawyer to tell me.
Well, I'd be interested to know what new ones are out there that I haven't heard of.
Okay, well, we'll see what the lawyer tells me. What all my rights are. It'd be pretty stupid of me to just start saying whatever you want to hear without a lawyer present or without a lawyer instructing me. On the right legal things to do.
Well, let's imagine something for a second here. Say 6 months from now, the police come and they visit you in jail. And they tell you that at what time are we at now? Whatever time in the morning it happens to be, 3:30 in the morning on Wednesday the 20th of May, there's a convenience store gets robbed just down the street from here. Same time that you and I are sitting in this room right now. They come and investigate it, and let's say they get a tip, somebody tells them, hey, Mike Rafferty robbed that convenience store. So they come and they arrest you for that robbery. You're telling me that you would not even consider saying to them, hey guys.
I never said I wouldn't consider that.
Hey guys, you screwed up. Go talk.
I never said I wouldn't consider that. And it's documented that I'm inside somewhere. It's documented that I'm sitting around with a bunch of police officers. It's documented that I'm on camera. So this this isn't something that I have to discuss with somebody.
But this
something
is the
else
truth.
Is something that
I, you're,
is best
you're putting
to,
out that the truth is.
I want to speak that, to a lawyer.
Yeah, you can speak to a lawyer all you want, but you're putting out the truth is
I'm done
that
talking.
You weren't there.
I'm
and
done.
That, yeah, I think that's a good idea, Mike.
Thanks. You said that earlier. I should have just.
I know, and you keep doing that. You keep saying I'm done. I'm not
okay,
talking anymore.
We're done.
And then you say, "Oh, I have an alibi," and
we're done.
Maybe I'll tell you. Maybe I won't. Maybe I need a lawyer here to tell me to keep my mouth shut because I can keep my mouth shut on my own.
Mm-hmm. We're done.
Is that what you said to Tori before you killed her? We're done?
Funny man.
Funny man. That's what you think this is funny man?
I think you're a funny man.
I think you're a cold-blooded killer.
You can think whatever you want. I've already denied that. Trying to get a rouse out of me? Not gonna happen. I already denied it. So
I don't need a rouse. The evidence tells the story.
You haven't gotten all your evidence.
No, it'll take us months, but it'll take us months and months and months. And you'll wait in jail.
Okay.
Until that happens.
Great. And then when it's all over, I can say bye-bye.
Bye-bye to what?
To you.
To freedom?
Yeah, right.
I'll be there to say bye-bye to you.
Okay.
Believe me, I've worked long and hard on this case.
Okay, good. Get ready to keep working.
I thought you weren't going to say anything anymore. Why can't you stop yourself from talking?
Why can't you just go away?
Because this is my job. This is what I do. 5 weeks of looking for you, I wanted to spend a little bit of time with you, Mike. This is gratifying to me.
Okay.
You and I haven't spent too much more time now than you forced Tori Stafford to spend in your car. You could have let her out anywhere along that route. You could have killed her without sexually assaulting her. And that's what I wanted to sit across from tonight. See what it's like to sit across from a guy who, when he abducts an 8-year-old girl, is so turned on by it that before he kills her, he has to have sex with her. So if you ask me why I'm sitting in this room, I'm sitting in this room for Tori. Making you squirm, putting you through some of the grief that you put her through. That's why I'm in here, Mike. And I'm having a good time. Morning, I'll have a briefing with my officers and I'll congratulate them for 5 weeks of good work, and then we'll get our first piece of evidence, then we'll get our second piece of evidence, then we'll get our third or fourth or fifth or sixth, who knows how many we're going to end up with, 20, 30, 40 pieces of independent evidence. It wouldn't surprise me, based on past experience, if we don't even need Terry Lynn as a witness when this is all said and done. Now that we know the route and we know all the ins and outs of what went on that day, everything else is going to tell the story. You are a sick puppy, Michael. This is a good day for us, because with any luck, you'll never be free again.
You'll need that luck.
I think we're going to get lots of it.
Sir, count your pennies.
Been here lots of times, bud. You're doing it again. You can't keep your mouth shut. Focus. Get about it now. Are you pissed off about the fact that this is Terry Lynn's fault? And she got one that was a little bit too old to let her go. Little bit too old that she would know what you guys look like. She'd know to tell the police what your car looks like and what you and Tara then look like. Should have done it yourself. Wouldn't that be a different story? You had the balls to do this yourself. You didn't have to send a 19-year-old girl kidnap an 8-year-old girl for you. You may not be here right now. You could have covered your own tracks. That's what happened to Bernardo too. That girl's biggest concern tonight was that was being interviewed. The part that I caught, she wanted to make sure she'd get into her car. She got tickets to go to Vegas in the morning. Something tells me she's going to go home and have a long, hot shower to wash the grime off. What do you think those people in that house in Guelph are going to say? They can guess what they're going to say. They're going to say, first of all, they're probably going to say, nope, don't know Mike, doesn't come around here. And then, when they find out, well, you think Mike might have done this murder, you really think they're going to be Big Mike supporters then? You think they're going to keep the faith and say, no, this lie for Mike? I don't think so. It's pretty hard to find support when that's the kind of thing you're accused of. People tend to tell the truth pretty quick. Are they going to be liars too? This is why we don't need you to say a word, but this is why you should keep your mouth shut. Because everybody else is going to tell the story. Eight years old, buddy. You're drug and adult, they go to the police. So you grab an 8-year-old stranger. All she wanted to do was go home, have a little party for her friends because her mom just redecorated her room for her. That's pure evil, but and that's all I've seen for the last 3 hours is pure evil from you. As much as that guy from behavioral sciences wanted to get all weepy and say, oh, poor me, the oxys, my poor grandmother, my poor mother, you don't give a shit about them. You don't give a shit anybody but you. And that's exactly what the judge is going to see. Because when the Crown Attorney calls the biologist to testify to the hair, the skin cells, the semen that was found on Tori, and the blood in the skin cells of Tori that was found in your car. And they're gonna play the video where you say, you're never gonna find my DNA on Tori. You're never gonna find Tori's DNA in my car. That's what you are. No remorse. No empathy. No nothing. You're just hollow. The nice thing about the place you're going to be spending a good chunk of your life is they actually have glass cells. So you and Bernardo can make googly eyes at each other all day, whatever you guys do in there. So it's nice meeting you, Mikey. Enjoy the rest of your life. This is the kind of room you're gonna be spending it in.
Michael, you're going to go back in your cell now, okay? Do you got a snack there that you want to take with you, or
okay.
Cookie? Yeah, that's fine. Okay. Back this way.